So now, listen. I want to create one file here. So I think to create file, we have one option called general. There we have file option here. Okay. So click on next button here. What is the file name? The file name, I told you, any file, any name. Okay, better you can give the name is cxf.xml file here. Fine. So in this file, we are already have something in the class notes. Come, go up, 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 up here, up. So we need to copy this schema also. Schema is mandatory. Okay. So up to the bins, up to the bins here. Paste it here. Okay. Fine. So here we need to copy this visual URL. Am I right? And this is your generated service interface here. That's it. And what is the tag we are using here? We should use the client tag. At the service side, at the service side also we'll write the configuration file, right? There we will configure our service class or not. There we need to use endpoint tag. Understood. If you want, I will this one cxfbeans.xml file is the configuration file. So what the tag name here is? Endpoint. This is your service class. I think you know everything. Address and ID, something like this. Understood? Client side, client tag. There we should use the endpoint tag here. Okay, fine. So now, so first let me copy this visual URL. Okay, I need to change it. This is visual URL. Correct? And now I need to change this generated service interface also, right? I think canal service, I don't know the package name. I need to get the package name also here. Package name durgasoft.service here. Correct? So now let me copy this. No, canal service. Correct? Canal service here. Configuration file is done. Configuration file is done here. Okay, fine. So just I'm giving here ID attribute can have any name. This one, this name should be, you should remember this, because this ID we will use in the client application, in our test client. And service class attribute can take generated SCI, I told you. And what is this address? Address will take what? Visual URL here. Correct or not? Fine. So now configuration file is done. Now you will create the client application here. In the client application, simple, what you will do now? You will create client application with main method. So from there, I think if you know the Spring, if you know the Spring, just we will use one class. So in that class, we will pass this ID. You will get this interface reference variable. And the interface reference variable, anyway, you have the method name or method or not. So you can invoke, that's it. Okay, fine. So now let me create client application here. So let us say I want to create client with conf file. Okay, so here fine. So we are already having the client in our application here. So here, come down here. Simple. See, let me copy this. Okay, code, and I will explain it. Just Control Shift O. Spring. Okay. So first you need to create your application context object here by passing your cxf.xml file. So this Java file is available in the src folder, and the cxf.xml file is also available in the src folder. That's why we are not passing any path. That is, if it is available in some webinf directory, you need to pass webinf something, like you need to pass it. And I told you the file name can be any name, and whatever the file name you are given there, you need to give that file name here, cxf.xml file here in our case. And then after creating this context object, you need to invoke get bean. That ID name we need to pass. In the client tag, in the cxf.xml file, we have used one tag, right? Client tag. There we have given ID or not. Whatever the ID you are given there, that ID you need to give. And you will get this interface, generated interface reference variable. You will get it here. That's it. And remaining things, you know that. Understood or not? Okay, great. So now just let me understood. So this is the way we can create the client application using Apache CXF implementation here. Okay. Yes. No, it is same. Only that generated interface will be changed. That's it. On that client application. Okay, it is same for any project here. Okay, fine. So this is the way we can create Apache CXF client application. Now we will discuss about the another concept called tracing SOAP request and SOAP response here. Tracing SOAP request and SOAP response here. So this is very important. In every web services we need to do this concept. Tracing SOAP request and responses here. So what is this tracing SOAP request and SOAP response here? Let us say I am a one web service, lot of people are invoking my services here. So he is invoking here. So I should have some acknowledgement, am I right or not? When you are invoking my request, maybe in future you are saying that I have not invoked. So definitely I need to show the proof or not. So how to show the proof here is, when you make a request, I will track your SOAP request, I will store it somewhere. When I send SOAP response to you, I will store that SOAP response somewhere. So that is for future purpose here. I hope you are understood here. Normally what will happen in IRCTC, or we can see like some online applications are there, shopping applications are there, right? What we will do, even sometimes we will pay the money, but we will not get the item or something, or we got some failure message something here. Immediately we will call to the customer care. So when we are called to the customer care, we will saying that just now I did the transaction using this so-and-so username and password, but it's not booked, but my amount is deducted from my account here. So how they will do that? So definitely somewhere this SOAP request and response will be stored. So they will open that request and response. Yes, we received, don't worry. Maybe due to some application issue or something. So we will again revert back your amount or something, they will tell. Because they are having the acknowledgement here. Understood the purpose of tracing SOAP request and SOAP response here. So I want to print SOAP request and response at the server side as well as the client side also here. Understood or not? So how to print that SOAP request and SOAP response? You can have two ways again. You can print the SOAP request and SOAP response in the console, or you can also store in some separate file, that is log4j. Using log4j we can store it. Understood. So here in this case, I want to print that SOAP request and SOAP response in the console here, in the server side as well as the client side also here. Can I do that now here? For this, very simple. Yesterday we saw that. Now this is the configuration file at the service side, right? CXF-beans.xml file. Yeah. There only we configured our service class. So here by default it has generated one. Listen. Tag. JAX-futures class equal to logging future here. So when you are using this future, automatically that class will take care to print the SOAP request and SOAP response at the server side in the console. Understood? If you want to print SOAP request and SOAP response at the client side also, understood? You can configure the same thing in your configuration file. Client side also, we have the configuration file or not? There you need to configure. That's it. In the client tag, you need to configure. That's it. This is a one way of approach to print your SOAP request and SOAP response. Another approach is also there. I will show you. Okay, maybe in your project, maybe you can use this approach or that approach also. I will show you both approaches here. Clear? So now, okay. So first, let me run client application without enabling this feature. So if I'm without enabling this feature, means what? The SOAP request and SOAP response should not be printed at the server side console. Am I right or not? Now let me do this. Where is my client application without configuration file something here? Okay, so now let me run this. See the console here. Actually, this is the client application. See the client console. Actually, you can go here. Listen, see here. Here. If you click on this, you will get the Tomcat console also. Which one is Tomcat? This one is the Tomcat. This one is your client console. Go to the console here. So there I don't have anything, only start up something here. Clear? Okay, now I want to refresh it. Now I want to enable that feature in the cxf-beans.xml file here. So when we change in the XML file, you need to deploy again your service here. So let me deploy it. So I want to remove all the application. I want to use only my application here. What happened? It's done. Okay. Now I want to clear the console now. Now I want to run your client application here without configuration. Any client, okay? So run as Java application here. This is client console here. Okay. Now I want to open the server side console. So listen. There. See. ID1 and ID1 here. Meaning what? This is for one request. This is displaying the SOAP request. This is displaying the SOAP response here. Payload means what? Maybe SOAP request or SOAP response here. Okay, how do you know that it's a SOAP request? Because we already know that what are the tags in the SOAP request. Correct or not? So now see the payload here. Okay, schema. This is body tag. Correct. And coming to add method here. What are the values we are passing here? 12 and 12 we are passing here. That is request here. And coming to the response here, see the ID1, same ID maintain. Meaning what? For the same request, we have the same response here. Payload, envelope. Return 24 here. Understood? Okay, so this is response here. Same way I want to print at the client side also. I told you what, just you can copy and paste it inside the that client tag here. So now let me do that even. This one. Copy and paste into this. Where is that cxf.xml file here? This one. Oh, sorry. This one we need to copy, right? This one we need to copy, and where we need to put it here? Insert this client application here. Now at the client console also, it will be printed here. So shall I run this application now? Okay. So now, see, client side also printing this ID1 and everything here. Clear? Okay. So this is the way we can track the SOAP request and the SOAP response here. ID2 only. Until you stop the server, it will maintain the sequential numbers here. Okay, fine. So I told you another approach is also there. So how to do that? Listen. So for doing this process, Apache CXF has given two interceptors, two Java classes they are given, interceptors. One is logging in interceptor, logging out interceptor. Logging in interceptor will intercept the incoming message. That message it will print it onto the console. Logging out interceptor will intercept the message. Which message? Out message means what? Outgoing message, and it will print that into the console here. Let us say, listen, I'm a service. I'm configured logging in interceptor and out interceptor to my service class. Understood? So what logging in interceptor will do? Logging in interceptor will intercept the incoming message. What is the incoming message for the service? SOAP request. It will print it onto the console here. What is the output message for the service? SOAP response here. So logging out interceptor having the responsibility to intercept the SOAP response, and it will print it onto the console here. The same interceptors I can configure at the client side also. So logging in interceptor and logging out interceptor. What logging in interceptor client side? It will intercept the incoming message. What is the incoming message for the client? It's response here. Logging out interceptor, out one. What is the out one from the client? SOAP request here. Understood or not? So first you need to, how to do that, how to configure that. Now first you need to configure those two interceptors in the service side configuration file or client side configuration file. Now you can map this interceptor to your service class. Why? Because in my configuration file I have more than one service classes. I want to intercept request and response for only one service class here. Understood or not? So that you need to map this interceptors to your service class. Understood? How to do that? I will explain now here. Clear? Okay. So I want to go to the class notes again. Come down. Another way, creating a client application. Apache CXF with the web service in Eclipse. We already did this. Come down. I don't want to do this. Okay. Spring integration, we will discuss about this. Okay. Tracing SOAP request and SOAP response here. I told you they are given two classes set. Actually, in the first approach, I didn't specify here. The first approach. And we discussed about second approach here. We have two interceptors here. That two interceptor, wherever you want to tracing, like client side or server side, in that side configuration file, you need to configure these two. Okay. Fine. So listen, how to do that? This is our service endpoint tag. We configured our service class here. Now listen, I'm to configure these two interceptors, you need to use the bean tag. Bean ID, some name you can give, class the fully qualified name of that logging in interceptor. Understood or not? And the same way, bean ID out interceptor and fully give them. Now you need to map these two classes to our service or not? So go up here. Listen, you need to use, for in interceptors, you need to use this tag, in interceptor, incoming request here. Jax WS colon in interceptors. So there you need to use ref bean, that interceptor ID you need to give. ID means what? Which one? This name. Understood? And the same way, out interceptor ID, that interceptor you need to give it here. Out interceptor. Clear? This is the way you can map it here. Let us, if you map same interceptors to another service class also, again you have another endpoint tag or not? From that endpoint tag, you need to refer those interceptors here. Can I do that now? Okay. So now let me copy these two first, correct? And go to this service side, the cxf-beans.xml file. Listen, just I want to use it. Now after endpoint tag, it should be under out of Now I need to refer it, right? So how to refer it? Again, I need to copy that. Copy, paste it here. Simple. If you want to do the same kind at the client side, what you will do? The same thing you need to do at the client side configuration file here. Now, can I run this application now? Okay. So now, this is client side console here. Now we need to open the server side console, right? So how to open? Just click on this Tomcat. There also we have 3 and 3. Why? Because third request it is. Clear? Okay. So this is about console here. Okay. Fine. So, and the same thing you can convert the client side also, client side cxf.xml file, and you can print the same thing here. So this is way we can trace SOAP request and do SOAP response here. Now I want to use the Spring integration here. Just I want to tell you the Spring integration, how to do that I will tell you. Okay, so to do the Spring integration, I want to create one example with some database interactions. Okay, so let me explain that example first, then I want to do the same example in the Eclipse here, okay, using Apache XF implementation. So now listen, see, I want to create service class. This service class wants to interact with the database here. Okay, so we need to write the database logic in the service class here. But I don't want to write this database logic here. Maybe I want to create another class. Let us say some DAO class. This is weather service. Weather service. And this is weather service DAO here. So all the database logic were available in this DAO here. Now this DAO is interacting with this database here. Understood? So whenever client makes a request, the request is comes to the weather service and then it goes to this, what's this, get this here. Understood or not? So what I need to do is I need to create this class and I need to create this class. If I'm using any user defined types inside the service IMPL class, I need to create that user defined types also here. So I have already that classes, just I will do the copy and paste it here. Why I need to write once again here. Okay. So just let me show you these classes in my class notes. Just I want to do the copy and do paste it here. Fine. Okay. So listen. First here, what I want to do. First I want to create the project here. Web service project. Dynamic web project. The project name is, let us say, Apache CXF. CXF. Weather service 2.5, finish button here. Okay, now here I want to take help from the Eclipse to create this web services here. Fine, but you need to create the service classes and these classes, Java classes, you need to create it or not? So no, so I want to copy those classes from my class notes. So go up, 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 up. Yes. So listen. So this is the DAO class. No. Okay, see. Listen, I'm creating one Java bean also. What is the weather? Java bean here is weather. Weather. City ID is there, city name is there, temperature is there. Okay. And then I have created weather DAO. Listen, weather DAO, DAO class here. So I'm creating one private method for getting the connection here. Okay. So now here, just we want to use get weather by city ID. Client is will send the city ID. Understand? And we are returning the weather object here. So for that, I'm getting the connection object. And here I'm writing some select star from where, which table, weather table. Weather table where city ID is something here. Understood? So you know this logic here. We will get the result set and we will iterate it and we will set that data into the weather object and we finally we will return that weather object here. Understood? And here same get weather by temperature. Get temperature by weather. Client will send that directly weather object. But from the weather we are getting only city name. Based on the city name we are getting the temperature here. Client will send the city ID or temperature. We will get city ID or city name. We will get the temperature here. Same query I have written here, but where I am using city name. Okay, same thing, temperature here. Okay, now I want to directly create this service implementation class. Even not interface is also not required here. Okay, so get weather by city. Just we are invoking that city ID. So here we are creating the weather DAV object or not. So after creating weather DAV object, we are creating these three classes here. So can I create these two, three classes here? So first let me create weather.java here. Let us say com.durgasoft.service. First I want to create that Java bin here, weather. Okay, I want to copy that weather here. So go up, let me copy this and next one weather DAV. So again, I want to copy this class here. Maybe import statements also required. DAV. I think not required to explain again because we are already saw this. Okay, now I need to create service IMPL class. Okay. So here directly what happening? Not Venkat, right? Yes, Durgasoft here. Okay, fine. Now let me create weather service. Finish button here. So come down. Interface is not required. Just I want to copy this. Simple. Okay. Fine. So service class is also done. Now we need to deploy this application to the. No. First you need to convert this service into the web service or not. So there you need to select Apache XF implementation not because we are taking help from the Eclipse here. If you are taking help from the Eclipse, what is the advantage you will get? Not required to copy the jars, not required to configure the skeleton in the web.xml file, not required to create the configuration file. So everything is done by the Eclipse here. Okay, that's why I want to take help from the Eclipse here. So how to do that? Just right click on the service class. Am I right? Now new, go to others. There you need to select what? Web services. There you need to select web service here. Click on next button here. Same, you need to change it. CXF 2.x and click on finish button here. OK. Okay, server is started. Just let me open whether we are getting any exceptions or not. Console, open the console. I think we are not getting any exceptions here. So I hope the service is good. So how to, okay. So now, first let me, after generating this, need to open the configuration file. Visual file, you know that. And web.xml, cxf. Now this is the main one here. And see, this is your service class, right? Am I right? Logging feature by default, it is enabled here. If you want, you can disable it here. Okay. So what is the address they are using? What is the address here? Weather service port here. Now compose the endpoint URL now. Compose. Can you compose? http://. Localhost 8080 / application name / skeleton URL pattern. URL pattern that is services / this address here. Correct or not? Okay, skeleton URL pattern is what? In the open the web.xml file. There you can choose the URL pattern. There we have the services. Correct? Okay. Now let me open this browser. So give this URL http://. Tell me. Localhost 8082. Okay. And application name is what? Application name is, just I want to copy here. / cal service / not cal service, sorry. What is skeleton URL pattern? How to know that? Go to the web.xml file. Web services. Correct? Okay. / address for your service which is in the configuration file. So now this one, correct? So now let me copy this. ? Clear. So what next? We need to create the client application. Client is simple. Okay. Fine. For this time, let me take help from the Eclipse. We will see whether it is generating or not. Okay. If it's not generating, again, manually we need to generate it here. Okay. Copy. Yes. Okay. Client application, right? So Apache. Again, you need to create dynamic web project. So Apache CXF